Thought of the name Beatles, and he'll tell you about it now.
I had a vision when I was 12, and I saw a man on a flaming pie, and he said, "You are Beatles with an A, and we are."
John put this thing in the Merseybeat, right, which was also started by Bill Harry, who went to art college with John, just saying that this little guy appeared on a flaming pie, you know, in the sky, and said, "Let there be Beatles," with an A.
John got the name Beatles ages ago, you know, when we needed a name, and everybody was thinking of a name, and he thought of Beatles.
I was looking for a name like cricket for them two things. We drew cricket, they got the Beatles. And you said it, people, they were crawling things.
Having seen the Wild Ones recently, I noticed that some of the bikers are called Beatles.
You missed them?
Yeah!
The Beatles missed you! Oh, the Beatles missed you!
When we started off, we had a manager in Liverpool called Alan Williams, who was a small bloke, a little sort of high voice, little Welsh accent, yeah, my lads. He was a great bloke, a real good motivator, he was very good for us at the time, you know.
He ran all the bands in Liverpool, and he first took us to Hamburg. Alan Williams came to us and said, "Okay lads, you can have this job in Germany. The only problem is you've got to be five people." He's asked for a five-piece band. At that point, Paul was the drummer because all the drummers didn't show up. And so, oh, that's when I said, "Okay, I remember this guy. We went up to this club and they were going to, you know, Pete Best, and we had this drum kit for Christmas."
He was known on Merseyside as Mean, Moody and Magnificent.
Pete Best. Yeah.
We got Pete Best just because we needed the drummer the next day to go to Hamburg.
John thought of the name Beatles, and he'll tell you about it now.
I had a vision when I was 12, and I saw a man on a flaming pie, and he said, "You are Beatles with an A, and we are."
John put this thing in the Merseybeat, right, which was also started by Bill Harry, who went to art college with John, just saying that this little guy appeared on...
John thought of the name Beatles, and he'll tell you about it now.
I had a vision when I was 12, and I saw a man on a flaming pie, and he said, "You are Beatles with an A, and we are."
John put this thing in the Merseybeat, right, which was also started by Bill Harry, who went to art college with John, just saying that this little guy appeared on a flaming pie, you know, in the sky, and said, "Let there be Beatles," with an A.
John got the name Beatles ages ago, you know, when we needed a name, and everybody was thinking of a name, and he thought of Beatles.
I was looking for a name like a cricket for them two things. And drew cricket for that to Beatles. And you said it, people, they were crawling villains.
Having seen the Wild Ones recently, I noticed that some of the bikers are called Beatles.
You missed them?
Yeah!
The Beatles missed you! All the Beatles missed you!
When we started off, we had a manager in Liverpool called Alan Williams, who was a small bloke, a little sort of high voice,
little Welsh accent, yeah, my lads.
He was a great bloke, a real good motivator, he was very good for us at the time, you know.
He ran all the bands in Liverpool, and he first took us to Hamburg. Alan Williams came to us and said, "Okay lads, you can have this job and join me. The only problem is you've got to be five people." He's asked for a five-piece band. At that point, Paul was the drummer because all the drummers didn't show up. And so, oh, that's when I said, "Okay, I remember this guy. We went up to this club and they were going to, you know, Pete Best, and we had this drum kit for Christmas."
He was known on Merseyside as Mean, Moody and Magnificent. Pete Best. Yeah.
We got to college. At that point, Paul was still playing the guitar, and I remember saying, "Well, one of us is going to do the bass," but I remember saying, "It's not me, I'm not doing it," and John said, "I'm not doing it either." He went for it.
You can't lie to me, I can't see. You can't cry because you're up and I'll be down, down.
And he became the bass player from that point on. So then we were a four-piece band.
When you know I'm down,
I'll give you laugh.
When you know I'm down.
And then we went back to Liverpool, got quite a few bookings, and they were probably in German. They were builders from Hamburg, and they said, "Speak good English." So we went back to Germany, and we had a bit more money to take them down. So we bought leather pants, and we looked like 4G Vincents, only a bit younger, I think. Anyway, we got back to Liverpool, and all the groups that were there, the sort of Shadows type of stuff.
That's why, you know, we became popular, because they couldn't believe it. There was all these dum 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 dum, and then suddenly we come on, Wild Men in Leather Suits.
I think it was Pete Best said to them that, you know, I would drive them to the gigs and stuff, and I think I got £1 a night, or £1 a gig, you know, 5 bob off each one. You know, they needed transport to get them to the cabin and whatever, because they were using cabs at the time.
We played the cabin before we ever went to Hamburg, I believe, when, in the days when it was a jazz and folk club. Seem to remember playing there and then handing us these notes saying, "Stop playing this music. This is a jazz club." So we were saying, "Well, now I would like to do this tune by Lead Belly, and it's called Until Sunny." You know, we do. And finally they kicked us off.
So anyway, we did well at the cabin and attracted some big audiences, and the word got around. What had happened was a kid had gone into Brian's record store and had asked for My Bonnie, which was an early recording we'd done with Tony Sheridan.